Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. So I'm here in my parents' home in Tennessee. My parents have lived here for over 3 years now. And this summer, my dad and eventually my mom as well, they're relocating to a different state. So while I honestly would have preferred to just stay in my apartment in New York, my mom really insisted I come down here and help them move. So just like I had done before, I packed some of my clothes and stuff into my suitcase and looked for the cheapest way to come down here to Tennessee. When I had to leave, it was actually a few days before the 4th of July weekend, you know, Independence Day and all that, so that meant I wasn't taking the plane. See, the cheapest one-way flight was close to like $400, too expensive. Although, strangely enough, I saw that a two-way plane ticket was actually cheaper. And on top of that, it was a non-stop flight. You know, I don't really know how that works, but since I don't really know what my return date to New York would be, I figured my next best option was taking the bus. This most recent time is like the fourth time I took this cheap bus in Chinatown to go to Nashville. So my parents usually want me to take the Greyhound, of course, instead. And they're right to point out that it'd be more comfortable. But, you know, as much as I dread taking this thing called the GoToBus, that's the name of the company, it really is the most affordable and the most expedient option. And, you know, right now I hope I don't sound like I'm advertising for the company, but seriously, GoToBus takes me from New York to Tennessee in 17 hours, and that's without a transfer, and all of that for $80. In contrast, if I took the Greyhound, that would take over 21 hours, require like 3 bus transfers, and the website's discount price, not just regular price, but the discount price, is around $170. So, yeah, looking at the numbers, I have the habit of gritting my teeth and just taking that much more affordable option. As you'd expect, the bus ride sucks for the obvious reasons. You know, it means riding in a large, cramped bus from 8 p.m. to 10 in the morning. And because it's so cheap, there are no empty seats, and there's hardly any legroom between the rows of seats. So there's all these people packed into this one large bus, and like there's tiny spaces in the seats. Sometimes there's good enough storage room below the bus for the suitcases, but on this most recent trip, I had to jam my suitcase into this like narrow and obscure crevice, so like it was really difficult to get it up there. This might be the cheapest way to get from New York to Tennessee, and vice versa, of course. And so it of course makes sense that it's the most uncomfortable way of traveling to here. One of the most worst sources of discomfort is the smell, actually. The last few times I rode the bus, I could barely tolerate the smell of the type of food people brought in. Now, I don't mean to sound like a rude jerk here, but the first thing I hope for when I get on this type of bus now is that I hope no one brought any Chinese or Indian food. I don't have anything against those type of food, you know, specifically, but when I'm stuck in such a confined space with hardly any legroom for over 17 hours, I want to breathe non-odorous air, air that doesn't smell, not whatever that stinky ethnic food is. Fortunately, you know, the problem is it goes away after people eat their food and put it away. The smell that doesn't go away is a more natural smell, and it's the smell that most other people in the bus won't really care about or will not know about. And that's because I tend to be a very nocturnal and person, especially on long bus rides. It's not easy for me to fall asleep. So come 1 in the morning, everyone else is asleep with their mouths open and snoring. And it's at that time I come to know all too well that no one's brushed their teeth. No one's had even the courtesy of taking any mints or chewing any gum. It just smells so bad. So until I can fall asleep, which can take quite a while, man, I loathe those open, snoring mouths. I always bring a case of mints with me, and I take it before I sleep. And every time, I just wish I can get up off my seat and just start popping mints into those open, germ-filled chasms that you call people's mouth. So, come morning, the worst part is that my arms and legs start to cramp. You know, I've been in this cramped space for over 10 hours. It's not like I can move around too much to deal with this because then I wake up the person sitting right next to me. The bus stops for like a 10-minute rest twice during the whole trip, and I'm glad to be able to kind of stretch a bit when that happens, but save for those short moments, the last 4 hours of this bus ride is a real test of endurance. You know, I gotta hand it to the bus drivers. There's usually a team of 3 that operate the bus, and they rotate so that one can sleep and the other 2 can continue navigating the bus. You know, one's driving, the other one has the map to kind of navigate and coordinate things. considering how cheap the bus tickets are, I have to wonder what the wages of the bus drivers are like. You know, the bus is filled with customers, so I'm sure they make a good amount of profit, but I suspect not much of the money actually goes to the workers who have it the roughest in the company, the drivers. So I trust them not to get too tired and get into an accident while I sit at the back of the bus, falling asleep from time to time and trying to ignore the awful smells when I'm awake. I don't really know how many more times I'll take this bus. I hope this is like the last time ever because my parents are going to a different state. But you know, every time I go on this, I realize that the thing about taking a bus from New York to Tennessee is that it can be so cheap, super cheap, $80. But of course, the another obvious thing is that it can really, really suck.